Hello everyone, and welcome back to my Let's Play for Indiana Jones and the Emperor's Tomb. We are just starting the Peng Lai Mountains chapter today. It's a longer chapter, so I'm hoping I can fit it all in one video, but we shall have to see. There's Indy getting in after the most awkward motorcycle ride ever. So I guess before I get started, I just got to apologize for some of the late, the uploading schedule recently. Damn right, Char. It's been kind of an erratic uploading schedule, and that's because, I have actually recently gone back to school again. And it is a super intense course. I went back for a medical lab tech certificate because apparently my bio degree is not very useful. So I'm going to try and upload as much as I can. But it'll basically just come down to when I have time to do it. I don't think I can really make a set schedule because I'm sure there are going to be some months that are just absolutely brutal. So I'm hoping it's not too bad, just letting you guys know that there might be a little bit longer of a wait. Put that away, you idiot. There might be a little bit of a longer wait between, videos. So I apologize for that. Okay, so you're gonna get into this little area, warehouse, whatever. And our objectives here are to get up to the fan. Up to the ventilation system to move to the next area. So I believe you have to come in here and pull this here. And this is going to open up the garage there. You can choose to shoot the Nazis in the parking lot or not. Like, it's totally up to you. When you're in this costume, they don't, like, do anything. Oh, okay. I guess as soon as you pull a gun out. Ow. Ow. This might have been a bad idea. There we go. So yeah, totally avoidable if you don't want to do that. I just shoot them because they're Nazis. Everyone knows they deserve death. Okay, so whether you kill them or not, the next area you're supposed to go through is into this garage here. And you can go through this little area on the, in the wall. And you're gonna get back here to this other section. I don't think there's anything down here, so don't bother coming down here. What you're gonna wanna do is just take this box up to here. Don't you fall off. And you're just going to want to come up here. And now we are on top, which is where we want to be. Before we go across that other way, though, what you can do is actually drop down here. Hopefully it doesn't take too much damage. Okay, perfect. And this is actually going to be the location of our first artifact for this chapter in this box here. It's going to be another idol. The Zauma Raitan or something like that. Up on the box. There you go. Okay. And yeah, once we're all done with that, you can make your way across to the other side of the room. I think we have to turn the fan off first, though, on the other side. Yeah. So that's going to stop the fan so we can get in through the vents, which is what we want. I think this guy attacks you no matter what, because he's another officer. So he's gonna automatically know that you're not a real officer, even when you're dressed up. There we go. Okay, and then you're gonna want to pull this to move this beam over. It clips. I love how it clips right through those big-ass vents. Laws of physics don't matter. And this is going to allow us to whip across to the vent shaft. which is exactly where we want to be. Just roll under that. Unfortunately, you're going to need to make some timed rolls here. Might be a good idea to use a med kit, just in case. There we go. Oh, piss off. Why are you not rolling? There we go. And just jump at the end there so you don't fall down the massive pit. Okay, we got another slow rolling one over here. Is there something over here? I can't remember. It's been actually a while since I did the first run through this.
Got a bad feeling about this.
Right. Is that where we're supposed to go? Shit. I think we can make it back. Come on, we can do it. Fight the fans. Okay, there we go. I'm just gonna go back to check if there's anything on the other side of this fan here. Because I really can't remember. Ah, and look at that, there is. It's a SMG and a little med kit. Perfect. Okay, so come through here first. Do I have anything in my canteen left? Of course not. There we go. Whew, a lot of breath holding in this one. So you don't want to slide right to the end. If you slide right to the end, it just leads into a pit and you die. You're going to want to come into this offshoot here, drop down here, and you're in another part of the... vents. You can't get that way. That one's spinning way too fast. Don't even bother. So we're coming in through here, and we can drop out of the vents into this little hallway here. Perfect. Another med kit down there for us. I think this might actually be close to the end of the level. Yeah, that's it. That's it for the first level. It's just getting out of the vents into the main facility. So that's nice. Oh, good. Now we get into the electricity part. Okay, this is one of the longer levels in the game. And apparently these guys know who I am, so I'm just gonna shoot them. Piss off. Oh, fuck. Hold the alarm, you little prick. Where is he? Open up the door. Oh, you dick. This needs to be turned right the fuck off. Okay. Our friends are back. At least we have weapons to deal with them now. They shouldn't be too bad. But anyway. So there's no power.
Power to the gondolas. There's gotta be a generator room around here somewhere.
So we gotta get the power going, unfortunately. Might as well shoot him while we're up here. Am I hitting this guy? This does not seem to be working well. I'll wait till they come up here. There we go. Next guy, want to make a try for it? No? Oh, there he is. That'll work. Perfect! Jesus, I have like no bullets left in this thing at all. Hope I can find some some ammo. Okay, so once you're done dealing with those guys, the first thing you're gonna want to do is come down here to the left, or the right, sorry. I believe there's a med kit in this one little crate, so you can use it if you need it. There's nothing else in any of these other crates back here. The big crates don't have anything in them. But if you keep going all the way to the end here, you're going to find this little box hanging out on the ledge. And that's actually going to hold the second artifact of this chapter. Another little scroll there for us. So moving right along. So our objective of this level, as you might have guessed, is to get the gondola stations going. Get the gondolas running on the tracks, because that's how we're going to progress to the next part of the base, anyways, through the gondola systems. Okay. Is there anything in these small crates here? I think there might be another med kit. Yeah. Perfect. Might as well use it, I guess. Perfect. Don't think there's anything back here. Nope. Fortunately not. And once again, nothing in these big crates. They're just decorations. Give me MP40 ammo. I need it so badly. Okay, this we need to pull. I believe it's going to start off the fans once again so we can get through the vent systems. Which is a whole lot of fun. Can't get through this door, or you can, but this one you can't. I don't know why they even bothered to put this in here. It's such a massive waste of space and everyone's time. The devs developing it. What the fuck? Why? Why is this here? Maybe it's like the fucking entrance to Diagon Alley or something, gotta tap some bricks. Okay, so get your way up to the vent here. Once again, roll under the fan like usual. I find it hard to believe you could do all of this in this, like, super bulky clothing. Like, it just seems like such a pain in the ass. So that jump there, be a little careful not to, like, jump right at the very end of your arc there, because I'm not sure if you can go over the fence or not. Oh. You found me. Oh, you did. No, none of that. I will happily take this off your hands. There you go. Enjoy your landing. Okay, so here we have a double whip. Same kind of thing. Like, just really watch yourself on that last jump, because I have a feeling that if it clips in just the right way, you might be able to go over the edge. Ugh, they keep seeing me. I don't know how. I will also take your gun from you. Still don't. Thank you. You want some? Go into the electricity. There we go. Perfect. So I'll just go through this little door here. And up to this room, and this is where we are going to turn on the power. And I absolutely hate this next section. This is probably the worst part in this entire chapter here. The alarm is immediately going to start going off, drawing a ton of guards to your position. Ow. Prick. Jesus. When does he open? No, you don't. There we go. So you can actually either do this one of two ways. What the game means for you to do is to walk through all this fucking garbage electricity. And find the correct safe path, which is how you're supposed to do it. But you can actually go back the same way you came in and just use the vents as well. So, I'm going to show you the way, like, the game wants you to do it properly, or at least try to, because I hate this. It is so, like, not well laid out at all. Like, how am I supposed to tell where I can go? Like, that's clearly blocked off. That's clearly blocked off. Yeah, no shit. While these guys are taking pot shots at you. Can you throw a grenade down? I'm gonna try and shoot this guy first person. There we go. So yeah, like, just be really careful about where you're walking here, because, like, it doesn't look like the electricity's gonna get you, but it absolutely will. And sometimes it's really hard to even see where the fuck it is and isn't. So once you get up to this switch, you're gonna wanna pull this switch, and it is actually gonna change the electrical patterns so that you're able to get back to the stairs, I believe. Yeah. Or no, not the stairs. You don't want to get to the stairs. You want to get to this other set out here on the outer layer. Like, look at that. What hit me there? What hit me? There was nothing there. But whatever. We got through. But yeah, like I said, if you don't want to go through all that bullshit, it is possible to, like, leave the way you came in, walk back up this catwalk, whip across back to that vent up there, and then just go back the way you came. The only tricky part is rolling underneath that fan without rolling out of the vent entirely. Can be a little bit of an issue, but it's not too bad. And now we're back in this room, where we came in through the vents once again. So now that we have power to the gondola stations, we can pull the switch and we can get them going. Just make sure you're pulling this switch and not the alarm switch. Okay.
The plume is there.
Nice. Pulled up the wrong gun, you moron. Oh. God, that's garbage. Okay, you want a fist fight? We can fist fight. Ow. 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 There we go. Oh, for fuck's sake. I don't need this. I don't need this right now, guys. I need med kits, because there is not a single fountain in this entire chapter. I don't think there's any fountain on the previous chapter either. So it is all med kits from here on out, and it is a pain in the ass. There we go.
Stealth in disguise. Time to ditch the goon suit.
And now we are on to the next level, which is a little bit different. It varies it up a little bit, and it's not too bad. On our lovely gondola system. But this gondola is actually going to fall off the line, so what you have to do is jump and meet these guys on their gondola. Just make sure it gets alongside you first. And just beat the shit out of these dudes. Just, yeah. Try and just hit them off the edge. Ow. And not go off the edge yourself. Okay, and now the fun part of the level comes in, where you protect the gondola from airplanes flying at it. And this is the rest of the level. It's just shooting down these planes in first person. At the gondola, you have the meter, the health meter of the gondola right below your health meter. So if the gondola takes too much damage, it'll fall down. And you die, either way. And this is it. This is the level. You just basically wait for planes to show up. Where are they coming from? And just keep trucking until you get to the end of the line. it's a little bit of a breakup of all the shooting and the platforming and stuff like that. So it's kind of fun. It doesn't last too long. Not too bad. I love how, like, Indy's taking out, like, their entire Earth. Like, what would they have left after this? They throw, like, 30 to 50 planes at him in this part. It gets kind of ridiculous. It takes, honestly, a lot to bring this gondola down, so, like, as long as you just keep blasting, you got unlimited ammo, so you don't have to worry about just aimlessly firing into nothing. I'm not gonna run out of bullets or anything like that. But yeah, if you stayed on the original gondola car that we were on, that's where you would have ended up, at the bottom of the canyon there. Like, how many do they have? One man taking out, like, an entire brigade of fucking fighter pilots. Like, don't you guys kind of need this for the war? Like, Jesus Christ. I guess this is supposed to take place in 36, so it's a little bit before World War II, but still. Like, dear lord. And he's setting back the German war effort by like 3 years. Just takes out their entire air force. Just insane how many resources they're willing to throw at one man. Like, guys, that only gets working. You can probably stop if you want to save some costs. You know, I'm just going to keep blasting away. Come on. We're trying to make it into that cave up there. Is the ultimate goal. But yeah, like I said, as long as you keep firing and, like, semi-aiming, like, decently, this level should not be that much of a problem. I think they only send, like, 3 or 4 of them at you at a time. So it's not too much of a challenge. You do have to figure out kind of where they're coming from. Almost to the end. Oh, Jesus. Decided to throw everything in the kitchen sink at us. Nice. I don't think there's a set number you have to destroy. I think it's just a timer. I think it just times you. Until you've basically been on the line long enough that the level ends. It's kind of a fun segment. I don't think there's any other segment like it in the game. There's the car segment, I guess, which is kind of similar, but this one, of course, is in the air. Come on, we gotta be getting close to the end now. And he just got hit in the face with a plane ring. Wing, I meant. Yeah, we gotta be. There we go. Done! And he has mysteriously disappeared from the top of the gondola car. Maybe he just went inside, I don't know. Okay, so now we got the airbase, which is kind of the last...
Not good. I need an edge.
Is the last level of this chapter, anyway. And right off the bat, you're immediately going to get a bunch of dudes running at you. God, I don't have, like, any ammunition either. It's a problem. Oh, you piece of shit. I'm in trouble. Let's turn this off. I think it's already too late. Nothing to see here. Where did they put it away? I thought he was dead. He was not. Oh, come on. Oh, man. I need ammunition. Give it to me, please. Oh, thank you. Just a little bit. You kicked that guy in the asshole, like, midway between firing. That was pretty impressive. I was impressed by it. Okay. I think if you come in here, there's another crate with some ammo in it. No? Fuck. This is why it's important to fight people when you can, I guess. Because when you need the... Oh, fuck. Grenade. Get this out of my face. That's going to be completely useful in these situations. Okay. I don't think there's anything back here. Those doors, I don't think you can go through. You're gonna get to the other side. This last level in the chapter is pretty much just combat. It's all pretty much just combat. This guy doesn't seem to have seen me, so... Nice. Got him without popping off a shot. Uh-oh. You're not going to that warning anytime soon. I actually don't think that's a warning. Paul, I think it's just opens the door. Med kit if you need it, which you might at this point, honestly. Yeah, I think this opens up the gate. Where there's even more dudes. That's what we need right now. Where are those? Try and just kill this guy. Nice. Get wrecked. Another med kit in here if you need it. And some MP40 ammo, which I really like. Yeesh. Where is he? There we go. Give me your gun. Just a very frantic level. Okay, now it's giving me lots of MP40 ammo. Oh, Jesus. Where did you come from? Thank you. Okay, so once you make it to this part, you're supposed to get through this door, but it is locked. Oh, god damn it. Why are you running down the stairs? Whatever. I'll take your MP40. Jesus, where are they all coming from? Okay, so what you're actually supposed to do before I was rudely interrupted by those animals. Oh my god! Do they just keep coming? Where are you, friend? Too many of them. Okay, I'm just ignoring them. I think maybe they just come until you're done. So jump up here, fall through this little hole here, and this is gonna take you to the next area, which is where we want to be. I'm not sure if there's an infinite amount of those guys, but I don't care. Go through the door. That door just leads to the outside. You can open it if you want to get back to the previous area. I really don't care. So I'm just gonna keep going through here. Kill those two dudes who are waiting to ambush us. And we're sitting in pretty good shape. I don't think there's anything in this room, to my knowledge. It's just a room where they try and ambush ya. Here, though, we actually do get the artifact. I think it's in this box here. The final artifact of the level, the Changan Stone, right to your left when you first get out here. Another dude wandering about. He's got a med kit and some Mauser ammo. How nice. I don't think you can get through here. Yeah. Just gonna be the last door on the catwalk. Oh, I thought this was the end of the level. Apparently it's not. There's one more. This is the last level of Peng Lai Mountains. I told you it's been a while since I played this. This one's fairly short though, I think. I saw that one guy had a machine gun, and I pussed out like crazy. I probably could have used this one, honestly. Okay. So if you come out here, you're going to get to the airstrip. So guess what it's time for? To mow down... Whoa, there's some. Let's not do that. There we go. It's time to mow down more planes. This time, they're not even getting out of the airbase. Enough of that. You guys aren't even going to be able to take off. Fuck you. There you go. You'd think as soon as one gets blown up in that tunnel, like, that would just be the end of it, but... Okay, that appears to be all of them. I don't think you actually have to do that, but it's up to you. Oh, there's two of them. Come on. The ultra aggressive playstyle. Revolver ammo. I haven't seen that in the blue moon. Okay. So the only way to go is actually up on this platform here. Oops. And we're going to whip our way across to the other platform. As precarious as this looks, that's the way you're supposed to go. And then drop onto this one here. There's another gun here for you if you want, if you didn't shoot the planes down beforehand, but don't really need it. I think it's there just so they don't annoy you when you're... Holy shit! Oh, come on. There we go. He was carrying a Mauser or two. That was surprising, and I didn't like that surprise. Yeah, I think the turrets are just kind of there, so you can mow down the planes so they don't annoy you while you're whipping across there. Take the elevator down to the lower levels. And we're gonna get a whole shit fest here going on again. A revolver. Oh, you dickhead. Don't you dare be bringing that shit into here. Blow yourself up, you dumbass. Man, what a troll. Like, wouldn't that be just the worst way to end this level? Is just get a grenade hawk at your face, like, in the last 5 seconds of this thing? Don't think there's anything out here. So yeah, I think the last thing we have to do is just call the gondola and then just hold off these guys until the gondola comes. And then we just run inside. Mausers out here. Lots of ammo now. Is there anything in these little boxes? Ooh.
Oh.
Just useless shit is what's in these boxes. Anything over here? Doesn't appear to be. Okay. So yeah, final stage of this level and this chapter is we just have to call the gondola back to our position. And then pretty much just defend it. It's gonna take a while to get here, so just pull out your gun. I think there's gonna be a couple guys showing up. They're pretty easy to dispose of. This guy's got a grenade because he's a fucking chode. No! A hat becomes more important than the dude pointing a gun at me. We got lots of ammunition. Oh, Jesus. I thought he had just a pistol. Can I shoot him from here? Absolutely not. Oh my fucking god. If you kill me, medkit time. There we go. And I think the gondola is probably there already. You betcha. And as a final fuck you to this level. That's probably gonna hit me from there. You watch. Oh. I was so afraid if I got up on here, that would hit me and blow me off the edge. Okay, then we have one final shooting segment. But I think you only have to kill, like, shoot down, like, 5 planes here. It's really not... really not worth your time. Is that it? Okay. Oh, no, there we go. Maybe if you don't shoot down the planes beforehand, there's more in this part? I don't know. But it's a pretty short segment. There we go. The last stragglers of a once great Air Force. And that's it! That's the end of Peng Lai Mountains. We are all now onto Black Dragon Fortress, which is when shit really gets serious. We are now in the end stages of the game. I think there's like 3 chapters left. But yeah, we will get to Black Dragon Fortress in the next video. I hope you enjoyed it, everybody, and take care.